गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. माई सेल्फ AK मखदूम, वर्किंग एज लेक्चरर इन शरद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी पॉलिटेक्निक एड्राव इन मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट. टुडे इन दिस सेशन वी आर डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग एडवांस मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसेस. द सब्जेक्ट कोड ऑफ दिस सब्जेक्ट इज 22563. The according to the MSBT curriculum, this subject which is given for the third year mechanical engineering students. So today we discuss regarding the overview about the syllabus, and there is the sample question paper for a final exam. So let us begin with the slide number one. There is the diploma in mechanical engineering. There is the program name. The program code is ME. Semester is the fifth semester. Course title like advanced manufacturing processes, and course code is the 22563. In this slide we take a general overview about the syllabus. First of all, there is this subject which is newly introduced in a iScheme syllabus of TY mechanical engineering students. So let us begin with this subject having a different course outcomes. According to that course outcomes, we are cover the syllabus, the course outcome and teaching examination scheme. That is the brief or maybe the detailed discussion about this teaching examination scheme, and there is the course outcome in a next slide. So let us begin with what are the contents under the practical sessions. In this practical for this subject, there is the minimum 24 practicals are required to cover, which are marked with a star. That are the compulsory practicals are there, and 1 to 13 these practicals are detailed reports of a machine specification, tool and workpiece specification, criteria of selection of process. That contents are which are required from 1 to 13. This is the various practicals are there. Out of 31, there are the 24 practicals here clearly mentioned in this syllabus. There is the 24 practicals are compulsory. So that's why in this curriculum or in this academic year, there is the 24 practicals are covered under this subject. So this is about the practicals which are related with our theoretical subjects. Next one is the major equipment instruments which are required for the conduction of various practicals. There is the list of equipments and which are required. This is the first one is the abrasive jet machining. This actually equipment which is required for a practical number 1 and 2. Likewise, there is the various machines which are required to conduction of various practicals for this particular advanced manufacturing processes syllabus. So there are the n number of machines which are required to conduction of practical sessions. So there is the list of equipments and their broad specification which are listed in this syllabus also. Next one is the theory components. What are the theory contents which are required to cover in this academic semester for this particular syllabus? The unit number 1 is the non-conventional machining process. This is the newly introduced the iScheme syllabus. So 1.1 fundamentals of non-conventional methods. Under that there is the needs and types of non-conventional methods, importance of methods, that contents which are covered under this 1.1 session. Next one is the 1.2. There is the working principle, setup process parameters of EDM, wire EDM, electrochemical machining, plasma arc machining, abrasive jet machining, ultrasonic machining, electro beam machining, laser beam machining. There is the under that 1.2, there is the working principle, setup, process parameter, these contents of various machining practices which is covered under this 1.2. Next is the 1.3, there is the advantages, limitations and applications of various machinings like EDM, wire EDM, ECM, plasma arc machining, abrasive jet machining, ultrasonic machining, electro beam machining, laser beam machining. That is the different advantages are there, different limitations are there, and according to the various machines, there are the different applications are also there. So this much content for this unit number one. This is the newly introduced chapter in this syllabus. Second one is the milling machines and milling process. That is the unit number two. This is the very important machine of a conventional machining practices, because milling is a very important machine for a shop floor area, because n number of various machining operations are actually carried out in this milling machine. So that's why this chapter, which is included in this syllabus, milling, that is the 2.1 working principle of milling, machine, types of milling machine, that is the very introductory part under the 2.1, which is covered under the this 2.1 session. Next one is the 2.2, milling cutters. There are the different types of cutters used in milling, like a face milling cutter, end milling cutter, staggered tooth milling cutter, side and face milling cutter, form milling cutters, metal slitting saw, etc. Means n number of various cutters which are required to carry out the milling operation. That cutters introduction and their types, that should be covered under the 2.2 session. Next, 2.3, there is the milling processes. In this, there are the different milling operations are actually carried out. What are the different processes are actually carried out over the milling machine? That contents are given in this session. There is the 2.3 milling processes. Plain milling is there, face milling is there, side milling is there, end milling is there, straddle milling is there, gang milling is there, slotting, slitting, up milling and down milling. There are the various milling processes which are carried out over that milling machine. That contents are given under this 2.3 session. Next one is the 2.4, cutting parameters. There is the various cutting parameters which is defined for that milling machine, like a cutting speed is there, feed is there, depth of cut. That parameter study which is given under this session 2.4, cutting parameters. Next one is the 2.5, dividing head. That is the very important attachment which is required for a milling machine, like a gear manufacturing process. For that purpose, dividing head mechanism which is required to manufacturing the gear over the milling machine. That contain like a types of dividing head, function of dividing head, method of indexing, index plate. That contents which is given under this dividing head, like a session of 2.5. Next, this much contents which are given under the unit number 2. Next one is the unit number 3, gear manufacturing. That is the one more important chapter which is included in this syllabus, that is the gear manufacturing process. Here there is the 3.1, gear manufacturing methods. There are the different gear manufacturing methods are there, various types of gears are available. That manufacturing methods are different. That content which is given under the 3.1 session. Next one is the 3.2, gear hobbing. That is the working principle of gear hobbing process. Types of gear hobbing, advantages, limitations, and applications of gear hobbing. That contents which are given under the 3.2 gear hobbing process. Next one is the 3.3, gear shaping. This one is the gear manufacturing process, like a gear shaping by pinion cutter, gear shaping by rack cutter. Advantages, limitations, and applications of both the methods, and comparison of gear hobbing and gear shaping. This is the contents which are given under the gear shaping of session number 3.3. Next one is the 3.4, gear finishing method. This one is the very important contents which is given in this unit number 3, that is the gear finishing method. Need of gear finishing methods, like a gear shaving is there, gear grinding is there, gear burnishing is there, gear lapping is there, gear honing is there. There are the various gear finishing methods, that contents which are given under this 3.4 session. This much contents from 3.1 to 3.4, which is covered under this unit number 3, gear manufacturing process. Next one is the unit number 4, that is the fundamentals of computer aided manufacturing. In this, there is the advanced technology which is implemented in the various newly started industry or advanced industry, how they are actually carried out the different manufacturing processes with the help of involvement of CAD, CAM and CIM technology in that industry. So under this syllabus of unit number 4, Fundamentals of Computer-Aided Manufacturing, there is a CAM concept is there, there is a NC means numerical control is there, CNC means computerized numerical control is there, and DNC direct numerical control. And next there is their concepts, features and differences, that content which is covered under the 4.1 session. Next one is the 4.2, CNC machines. There is the types of CNC machine, classification of CNC machine, working and constructional features of CNC machines, advantages, limitations and selection criteria of CNC machine, that contents which is covered under the 4.2 session. Next one is the 4.3, elements of CNC machine. There is the types, sketch, working and importance of slide ways, recirculating ball screw, feedback devices like a transducers, encoders, automatic tool changer means ATC, automatic pallet changer, there is the APC, that type of elements which are briefly introductory part which is given under this particular session, like a 4.3, elements of CNC machine. Next one is the 4.4, CNC tooling. That is a very important content which is given in this particular topic. There is the CNC tooling, like a tool presetting concept is there, and importance, qualified tools, definition, need and advantages. Next one is the tool holders, types and application. Means there is the introductory part of tooling of CNC machine, which is given under this 4.4 session. Next one is the 4.5, CNC turning centers. There are types, features, access nomenclature, specification, work holding devices, types, their working and application, that contents which are given, which is given under the 4.5 session of CNC turning centers. Next one is the 4.6, there is the CNC machining centers, various types of CNC machining centers, features, access nomenclature, specification, work holding devices, types, working and applications, that contents which is covered under the 4.6. So this much contents which is covered under the unit number 4, Fundamentals of Computer-Aided Manufacturing, or in short, there is the CAM. Next one is the unit number 5, CNC part programming. There is the very important chapter according to our exam point of view. This chapter is very important for a scoring purpose or improve the score of this subject. So under this topic, there is the definition and importance of various positions like a machine zero, home position, workpiece zero, and program zero. Means at the initial stage of a programming, what is the basic concepts you know, like what is the meaning of machine zero, what is the meaning of home position, what is the meaning of workpiece zero. That is the introductory part of programming, which is covered under the 5.1 session. There is the definition and importance of various positions like machine. Next one is the CNC part programming. Programming format, how we can write the program of a CNC machine, what is the structure of that part program, that content which is covered under this 5.2. Next one is the 5.3. There is the ISO, GNEM codes for turning and milling machining, and applications of important codes, means which codes are required to create program for a turning and for milling also. There is the GNEM codes which are defined by that ISO standard codes are there. That codes, what is the meaning of each and every code, that detailed study about the GNEM code of ISO of turning and milling machine, that contents which are covered under this 5.3 session. Next one is the 5.4, simple part programming for turning using ISO format, having a straight turning, taper turning and convex concave turning, like a circular interpolation. Means how the program for a turning we are right over here, that content which is covered under the 5.4. Next one is the 5.5, simple part programming for milling using ISO format. Same like a turning also, there is a simple part programming for milling that content which is given under this 5.5 session. Next one is the 5.6, importance, types, applications and format for Canada cycle, micro, do loops, subroutines, etc. Means simple way of preparation of the program, that is another one method for a special purpose or purposefully do the programming for a carry out the various application oriented operations over that component. For that purpose, there is the Canon cycle is there, micro is there, do loops is there, subroutine. Means these are the various types of programming methods that should be covered under the 5.6 session. Next one is the 5.7, CNC turning and milling part programming using Canada cycle, do loops and subroutine. Means for turning and milling, we want to prepare the program for in the format of Canada cycle, do loops and subroutine. That is covered under the 5.7, CNC turning and milling part programming using Canada cycle, do loops and subroutine. Next one is the 5.8, need and importance of various compensation. Compensation is a very important factor while you preparing the program for either it is a turning program is there, either it is a milling program is there. How you can define the compensation at an initial stage of a programming, that content like a tool length compensation is there, pitch error compensation is there, tool radius compensation is there, tool offset compensation is there. This type of a compensation we are defined at an initial stage of programming, that part or that contents which are covered under this 5.8 session. Next one is the 5.9, simple part programming using various compensation. With the using of compensation, we want to prepare one part program that content which is covered under this 5.9 session. Next one is the virtual CNC machine simulators. This part is very important. With the help of different simulator tools, we can easily prepare the CNC programming and observe the how the tool is travel from the initial stage to the finish stage. There is the tool path, how the machining is carried out. There is easily you can observe with the help of simulator software, and that contains like a generation of shop documentation, like using a CAM software is there, cycle time sheets are there, tool list with the tool layout, spindle utilization graphs are there, program for different control systems and different configuration of machine. Means this type, this much contents which is covered with the help of there is a various simulator tools which is covered under the 5.10 syllabus. Next one is the unit number 6. This is the last unit for this syllabus. There is the automation and robotics. This is the very important unit because there is the advanced machining practices, how they are handled, like automation is there, how the robotics which is introduced in a newly started industry and how they are using that robotics and automation in the industry, what are the different types that contains, like automation, what is the definition of automation, need of automation, high and low cost automation, examples of automation. That is the introductory part of automation which is covered under the 6.1. Next one is the 6.2, types of automation. Here there is the fixed automation is there, programmable automation is there, flexible automation is there. Comparison of types of automation means there is the various types of automation, how we are implemented in the industry, that contents which are covered under the 6.2 session. Next one is the 6.3, group technology, the concept of group technology, basics for developing part families, part classification and coding with example, concept of cellular manufacturing, advantages and limitations of group technology. That much contents which are covered under the 6.3 session, group technology. Next one is the 6.4, flexible machining system. There is the, in short, there is the FMS, introduction of FMS, concept, next definition and need, subsystems of FMS, comparing with other manufacturing approaches. Likewise, there are the different flexible machining system under that. These contents are covered under the session of 6.4. Next one is the 6.5, introduction to robotics. Means related to robotics, what is the definition of robotics is there, advantages and disadvantages and applications of robotics. That much contents are covered under the 6.5 session. Next one is the 6.6, components of robotics, like a manipulator is there, end effector is there, actuators are there, sensors are there, controllers are there, processor and softwares are there. That much contents which are covered under the 6.6. So this much syllabus which is covered during the theoretical contents, one by one unit we are covered. But while we observe the syllabus, there is the too much contents are given under the each and every topic. But as per my view, there is a this unit number 4 and 5, this is a very important and which is having a maximum weightage as per there is the guidelines from the MSBT, which is mentioned clearly at the end of this page. Here clearly they are mentioning how much time is required to cover one syllabus, how much lectures are allotted for that unit. Here there is the unit number 1 having a 10 hours required to completion of this all contents which is mentioned in under the non-conventional machining methods, and marking weightage out of 70 there is the 12 marks weightage for this unit number 1. Unit number 2, there is a milling machines and milling processes. The teaching hours which is allotted for this topic number 2, there is the 10, and marking weightage for this unit number 2 is a 12 out of 70. Next one is the gear manufacturing, unit number 3. The teaching hours which is allotted for this unit number 3 is a 10, and marking weightage for unit number 3 is a 10 out of 70. Next one is the unit number 4, fundamentals of computer aided manufacturing. The teaching hours which is given for this syllabus, there is the 10, and marking weightage for this unit number 4, there is the 12 marks weightage out of 70. Next one is the unit number 5, CNC part programming. The teaching hours given for this chapter number 5, there is the 14 hours are mentioned in this syllabus, and marking weightage for this unit number 5 having a 16 out of 70, and compared to other chapter, this chapter having a maximum weightage. Next one is the unit number 6, automation and robotics. There is the teaching hours given in this syllabus, there is the 10 hours, and marking weightage for this chapter, there is the 8 marks weightage out of 70 marks. So this is the description about how the teaching hours are given to that particular unit 1, 2, 3 up to 6, and what is the marking weightage is given to the unit 1 to 6 out of 70. So last one is the suggested learning resources. There are the various learning resources or title books are available, and their author names, publication, these all books are available in our library also. So this much overview about the advanced manufacturing processes syllabus. Next, one more important thing in this syllabus, there is the teaching and examination scheme. Here there is the first one is the lecture hours which is given for this syllabus. There is the 4 hours per week allotted for this syllabus, and 4 practical hours which is allotted for this advanced manufacturing. Means total weightage for this syllabus covered per week is 8 hours. Next one is the paper hours. There is the 3 hours paper is your end semester exam. Next one is the there is the end semester exam. 70 marks of your end semester exam is there. Out of 70, 28 marks for required for the passing. Next one is the practical, your PA. PA means your theory submission is there. 30 mark distribution is clearly given for the theory subject also. There is the 10 marks which is given for the submission of micro project. of this particular syllabus, and 20 marks which is depends on the unit test 1 and unit test 2. Average of these two tests which is conducted during the semester, there is the marks are considered for this under the theory PE. Next one is the practical. There is practically having a end semester exam is also there. 50 marks weightage for the end semester exam means your oral and practicals which is conducted under this practical. So out of 50, there is a 20 minimum marks are required for a passing purpose, and there is the submission. 50 marks is there. Out of 50, there is the 20 marks minimum required for a every student for a passing purpose. So there is the practical having a 100 marks weightage and theory having a 100 marks weightage. So overall weightage for this particular syllabus of advanced manufacturing processes for 200 marks. So that's why be aware about this syllabus, be aware about this subject, because maximum weightage which is given in this curriculum for this syllabus and which is helpful for improve the score of your final year. So this much about the syllabus. Or next, there is the structure of question paper. This is the very important. Each and every student must know the how the question paper which is designed for the final exam. Because if you know the clear idea about the paper design and how much weightage for a question, then and then only it is easy to attempt the question paper at the end of this semester. So this is the subject. Code is 22563. The hours given for the question paper, there is the 3 hours, and maximum marks for this subject is a 70 marks. So first question which is having a 10 marks weightage, each question having a 2 marks. Out of 6, out of 7, there is the 5 questions you want to attempt. 5 multiplied by 2, 10 marks weightage for this question number 1. Question number 2, which is having a 12 marks weightage, there is the out of 4 questions, you must attempt the 3 questions. 4 multiplied by 3, there is the 12 marks weightage is given for this question number 2. Question number 3, which is the same like a question number 2, here there is a 12 marks weightage is given for a question number 3. In this also, there are the 4 questions are asking. Out of that 4 questions, you must attempt the 3 questions. 3 multiplied by 4, there is the 12 marks weightage for a question number 3. Next, question number 4. This question number 4, which is also having a 12 marks weightage, like a question number 2 and 3. Here, there is out of 4 questions, you must attempt the 3 questions. 3 multiplied by 4, there is a 12 marks weightage for a 4 number question. Means question number 2, 3 and 4 having a 12 marks weightage. Next, question number 5, there is the only 2 questions you want to attempt. Here, there is the 3 questions are there. Out of that, you want to attempt the 2 questions. Each question having a 6 marks weightage. 6 multiplied by 2, there is the 12 marks weightage for a question number 5. Next one is the question number 6, which is the same like a question number 5. Here also, only 3 questions are asking, and out of that 3 questions, you want to attempt, there is the 2 questions. Each question having a 6 marks, 6 multiplied by 2, there is the 12 marks weightage for a question number 6. So this is the overview about the sample question paper of your subject of advanced manufacturing process. So while you attempt the final year question paper or final semester question paper, at the same time you prepare the this sample question paper, because this is the structure of question paper is defined over here. This is the guidelines from the MSBT. You prepare these guidelines because it is helpful for improve the or cover the maximum questions at the time of examination. So that's why this question paper or this sample question paper is very helpful to improve the your score for a final end semester exam. So this much about the sample question paper. which is mentioned over here, this much contents which is under the structure of question paper. So this is the overall overview about the advanced manufacturing process syllabus. Thank you. Thank you very much.